and welcome to the session. In this session, we will discuss sales tax and VAT. First, let's discuss sales tax. Sales tax is a consumption tax which has to be paid while purchasing some goods and services. This additional amount that we pay is at a rate specified by the government, and also the sales tax is added to the cost of the commodity. We can also say that sales tax is an indirect tax. That is, when we purchase some specified items from the market, we have to pay certain extra amount which is at the rate specified by the government in addition to the cost of the item, and that extra amount is the sales tax. Sales tax is calculated in the same way as we calculate the percentage. For example, if the cost of a CD player be given as $200, sales tax of 8% is charged on the purchase of the CD player. So this means amount of sales tax would be equal to 8% of 200, that is 8 upon 100 into $200. This is equal to $16. This is the amount of sales tax. So, after charging a sales tax of 8%, let us now find out what would be the total cost of the CD player . This would be equal to the cost of the CD player, which was $200, plus the amount of sales tax charged on it, which is $16. And so this is equal to $216. This is the total cost of the CD player. So if a person wants to buy a CD player of cost $200, on which a sales tax of 8% is charged, then he will have to pay $216 to buy that CD player. Next, let's discuss about VAT, that is the value added tax . VAT is a tax on the value added to a product, material or service at each stage of the manufacturing distribution chain. Now the manufacturing chain consists of the manufacturers, which could be more than one, and the distribution chain consists of the distributors, the wholesalers, the retailers, and after that the commodity reaches the consumer, the seller charges VAT to the buyer and the seller pays this VAT to the government. VAT is collected by the state governments. Let's discuss some points on computation of VAT, that is value added tax. First we have that the VAT is calculated on the value added by the dealer. So if suppose that a dealer buys any article or an item for $100 and he sells that item for $120, then he will pay the VAT on the value added part only, which would be 120 minus 100, that is $20. So on $20 only VAT would be charged. Then next we have VAT is charged at a specific rate on the selling price of the items. Next, if discount is allowed, then VAT is calculated on the net selling price, that is the selling price of the article after deducting the discount, that is the net selling price. Like for an item, if the selling price is $100 and discount is say $20, then its net selling price would be 100 minus 20, that is $80, and so VAT would be calculated on this net selling price. Next is, a dealer pays VAT at the time of purchase and he charges VAT on the selling price while selling the item. Now, as the consumer is the last tax point, so the VAT paid by the consumer is equal to the sum of the taxes paid to the government at various stages of transaction. Let us now consider an example in which we have that a trader buys an item from a wholesaler for say $1,000 and it's given that the rate of VAT is 5%, then the VAT paid by the trader to the wholesaler is 5% of $1,000. That is 5/100 into $1,000 is the VAT paid by the trader to the wholesaler. So this is equal to $50. Now if the trader sells the item to a consumer for $1,200, then the VAT paid by the consumer to the trader is 5% of $1,200, that is 1200 into 5/100 dollars, which comes out to be equal to $60. As we have that the trader buys an item from the wholesaler for $1,000 and he sells that item to the consumer for $1,200, so this means that the trader has added $200, that is $1,200 minus $1,000, to the value of the item. Now, the VAT paid by the trader to the government would be 5% of $200, which is equal to 5/100 into $200, and so this is equal to $10. Now let's find out the total tax paid to the government. Now this would be equal to the VAT paid by the trader to the government, which is $10, plus the VAT paid by the trader to the wholesaler, which is $50. So we have $10 plus $50, and this is equal to $60. This is the total tax paid to the government. We already know that the VAT paid by the consumer is the sum of the taxes paid to the government at the various stages of transaction. So this is equal to $60. That is, VAT paid by the consumer is $60. So this completes the session. Hope you have understood the concept of sales tax and VAT.